Hey, this is Fly Guy back again with another figure review. Yet again, Marvel Legends, who dominate this year in 2016 with just a ton of releases. If you're brand new to the Marvel Legends line, this is generally a 6-inch figure line, and you've got no shortage over the last year of collecting everything from X-Men to just, you name it, pretty much every comic version has been rendered this year, it seems. All about 6 inches in height, just about. Vision just a little bit, just hitting the mark there, just over 6 inches. And these are a Toys R Us exclusive in both the US and Australia. I'm not quite sure about the UK. The US pricing is $50. The Australian pricing works out at $75. And again, I've no idea about the UK. So if anybody's out there knows about the UK price or Germany or any other countries you've seen this in, please let us know. Leave a comment below. A couple of links below underneath if you want to go and buy it. And let's get a quick look at these. Now, the packaging, good friend shipped this from me from overseas, which is great. Thank you very much, dude. You know who you are. So the packaging, we've just got a little bit here to show you. It really wasn't very impressive anyway. Kind of fairly standard window box. And as you can see, the back of the packaging, the picture of Marvel's Vision, Sam Wilson, and Kate Bishop, the younger version of Hawkeye. And that's pretty much it. Standard window box. Nothing really exciting about it overall. Let's get a look at the figures. First up, let's go look at the Vision. Vision is reused and retooled pretty much from the previous Vision that we've had recently, the comic version. There's a review on our channel if you want to check it out. Just put the word Vision into the YouTube search on the top of our page, you'll get it. But it's pretty much the same. They've reused the legs and, in fact, pretty much everything, really. So you're really getting a bit of a repaint. The cape is different here. We've got a much more recent version of... I mean, this is a more recent version of Vision, I should say. So his cape is a little bit more reminiscent of that. And I think they've done a pretty good job. Lots of little scratches and marks here and there. It's a little disappointing overall because this is, again, I'd have loved to have got a movie version of Vision in here. This would have made a perfect addition to this set, given that everything in here is just really all just very easy repaints and retools. But it's a good looking figure nonetheless, not too bad. Again, if you're a fan of the recent Vision comics, which are particularly good, this is pretty nice. The cape is removable. You can pop it off, little peg at the back, and you can see all this articulation. Dead easy, dead simple. There's as far back as his head will go and as far forward as it'll go. You'll see, and obviously that's a swivel as well. Ball joint up at the shoulders, standard stuff here. Double joints at the elbows, swivel wrists with that ball joint there, gives you that extra flexibility. The same on the other hand. Now the only difference that I can think of from the last Vision is we got a kind of weird hand on the last one, which was a kind of larger kind of hand like that, kind of pressed out, not that size obviously, but it looked a little odd. So at least now we've got two fists that look of the right scale. You can see the ab crunch there, goes forward and swivels around, so pretty good, decent movement. Up at the top, as usual, pegs up there, swivel for the tops of the thighs, double joints at the knees, rocking ankles, and peg holes for those things that Hasbro never give us. So damn you, Hasbro. So that's a Vision. Let's get him out the way and look at Kate Bishop. What we do get here with Kate is the bow, which has been used many, many times before in the Marvel Universe. This time, we get some paint. We're spoiled, people. We get a little black paint on top of this. So rather than just being a lump of black plastic, they've at least tried to be a little bit more accurate there. So we've got silver chrome spray on most of it. It's exactly the same as far as I can tell. With that little black bear. This seems very rubbery, this piece here. Not quite sure what's different here than before. The last one seemed very much harder and more difficult to pull. Sadly, yet again, no arrow in this pack, which is just, I don't know why. We get a little quiver down here on her belt, which kind of plugs in. You can see that piece there if I just pop it off. And it looks like an arrow could go down there, but that only goes down to kind of about there. So you can't even get an arrow in it. So I don't really know the point in doing that. It was like kind of a little odd. Anyway, we get the little purple tipped arrows in there, and it's a pretty nice looking quiver as quivers go. It looks pretty good. She's got this belt here, which is just loose, obviously, around her waist, and the quiver just, as I said, plugs in. It's kind of a pain, I think, posing-wise. I mean, that's the way she looks, but it just doesn't seem to work. I kind of tend to prefer to move it really just all the way around a bit because it just gets in the way of articulation and hands. But that's the way she looks. Reused bits and pieces here from, as far as I can tell, Spider-Woman. There's some definite similarities to the recent, which we've yet to review, Spider-Butt going on here. So it looks a lot of reused bits and pieces from Spider-Woman that has been reused here to make Kate. Obviously, we get a brand new facial sculpt. And I think they've done a really good job. It's really nice. She's got cool little gold shades going on with that little tinge of purple in them. It's nicely done in that cute kind of cut here, the way it's going on, and the bow in her hair, or band in her hair, the way you call it. But it's just, overall, there's no tone, there's no wash, there's nothing else. It's just, that's all you get. So it's a little, not too exciting. But look, not bad, we're getting a Kate Bishop, so I guess we should be glad. Again, articulation here, you can see, can't really move that head back much at all because of the lack of the movement with the hair. Let me see if I can focus a little better. And so really, you're not going anywhere. That's it. That's all you're getting articulation-wise. You really can't move much more because of that cut of the hair. That's just the way these figures go when they've got their hair cut like that. Again, articulation, ball joint up at the top of there. Single joints on the female elbow is pretty much standard these days. Down to the wrist, ball joint on the wrist, which is a little thin on those fingers. They can bend pretty easily, so watch them. But again, plenty of movement and articulation on there. Upper torso swivel. She's got plenty of movement going on, so pretty good. Down, no waist articulation. Tiny little belly button. You can just see that there. Up to the pegs up at the top of the legs. Swivel on the tops of the thighs. Double joints on the knees. Yay. And down to the rocking ankles. So plenty of movement going on there. And these little boot pieces seem to be just kind of able to move back and forth. Peg holes for the things that Hasbro never give us. So there you go, that's Kate Bishop. Now finally on to Sam Wilson. Biggest disappointment here, there's no wings. How cool would this have looked if Hasbro had given us something like that? We would have got an epic figure in this pack. Down to cost reasons, probably, they have scrimped on this one, and it's just a real shame, because this is a really good-looking figure. Now, a lot of this is retooled from the Marvel Now Captain America, again, reviewed on the channel. Just click Marvel Now or Captain America, you should find the review. So the legs pretty much are all the same from the caps before, as are the gloves up to the biceps, and this, I don't know what's going on here, there's some really large bulbous. It seems really weird, the size of these, I don't know what you would call, I can't remember the tops of these shoulders there, muscle-wise, but yeah, they're kind of odd. They look a little weird, but not too weird. The shield is very flat and no shine to it whatsoever. It's very kind of flat in shape as well. It doesn't really feel very concave as the shield should. Very white and no metallic kind of essence on it whatsoever, so it's not too bad, but not too great either. We get that little clip, you've seen this many times before if you've seen a cap figure, clips onto his arm there, or take the peg out the back and turn that down there, and you'll see that then clips into his back eventually, and you could have his shield displayed as such. No paint on the underside of it, which is a little, again, you know, come on guys, just do a little paint there. Just, it was a little bit miserable. Little silver dots in there or something for the straps. It just feels a little nasty not to do that. The figure itself, again, nice little touches of the silver paint on the figure, round about the belt. I love the detail up at the top here, round across the chest emblem. It's really nicely done. It's kind of raised grooves, and it's just, it's made the paint, although a little sloppy in parts, stand out really well. Sam's face, good recognition, I think, there from the comic version. It really does look good. Little bits of silver, obviously, in the shoulder up at the top, and on the belt, and down at the knees. It looks good. It's a good-looking Sam Wilson. I think it's a good-looking figure. Just badly, badly let down by the lack of wings. It's just, that's just cheap. It's just cheap. So, that's really annoying. So, I think what's going to happen with this pack, kind of like the Marvel Legends Shield 3-pack, which is $25 Australian in stores, which is about $18 US. And I think, I bought a few packs in America, the same set, is down to about $20 over there too. So three figures for $20 is a deal. At $75 in Australia or $50 in the US, this pack is really about $20 overpriced. These are worth about $15 each, I would say, at the very most. these figures. Sam, probably the best out of the lot, I would say, and Kate Wilson, if you're a fan of that. But good figures all over, not too bad at all. Very quickly, the articulation on Sam, that far head up, that far head down, so pretty good movement overall, and it's got that joint so it can move all the way back a little bit there. These huge, bulging, ridiculously sized shoulders allow a swivel and a ball joint there. We got a swivel on the bicep, down to a double joint on the elbows, and down to a joint with a ball joint swivel at the fists. You'll see the crunch, the ab crunch makes a nice audible click back and forth, and swivel waist up to the usual standard pegs up at the top, swivel up at the top of the waist, double joints at the knees, rocking ankles and all together, everybody. Peg holes for those things that Hasbro never make us. So there we go. It's a good pack. I do like it. I'm in love with Marvel Legends this year. They've really kicked it. And a great deal of figures still yet to review. The brand new Spidey Wave we will have for you just to review just after this. So there's plenty of new Marvel Legends out there and coming. And they're looking pretty good. Just a shame this one is a little bit kind of mediocre in terms of repaints and repacks and retools. And it's just, it's a little bit of a kind of nasty ploy. But look, that's Marvel Legends overall. They're really there to be repainted and reused, and that's why we can get so many characters. But love to know what you think of these figures. Let us know about Kate, Sam, and Vision. Please do leave a comment below. Let us know. Brand new to channel, you know the drill. Click subscribe and you'll get all sorts of goodies straight into your inbox. Podcasts and reviews, all that stuff. And yeah, that's it. Let us know or give the video a thumbs up if you liked it. And we'll be back with more reviews coming up soon. Cheers.